So once again, fellow Biafran lovers of freedom, men and women of goodwill, conscientious people wherever you are all over the world, I say good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and to some of you, good night, depending on your time zone. This is Radio Biafra Extra, and we are streaming live through Radio Biafra London, being anchored by the deputy leader of the indigenous people of Biafra. His name is Mazu Chuka Fomefo. He is from Abatete. Abatete is in Anambra State. And Anambra State is Biafra land. He's the man who have assured us that he will not allow the heart of this project to see corruption. Mazi Chuka Fomefo is standing on a deputizing capacity on behalf of our supreme leader, Mazen Nandi Okukano, the prince of Afari Ibeku, heir to the throne of Ibeku kingdom, the one and the only man that stood up to speak for the collective interest of the Biafran people. He's from Omuahia, Afali Biku in Omuahia, to be precise. Omuahia in Abia State, Biafra land. He is the man who have assured us that Biafra must be restored. A servant of the Most High, I must tell you. Nobody commands our loyalty. Whatever he say, we do. By the grace of Chukwuka Igabiama, I remain George Unyibi. I am from Abo. Abo is in Delta State, and Delta State is Biafra land. By the special grace of the Almighty Creator, Chukwuka Igabiama, we will not proceed until we acknowledge him, because in the end, he is the lifting up of our head. And so in my humble way tonight, I say to him, Anye na ja ge mau, ima kwa ne zyoku, ne maramaye, e honanya ene na ge ubiomage, o juru anyanya dadio, ingwe ge mbangwe o, o digo nye de kage, ibu wafa no mega, anye ne ne na se na ne de mau. Of course, without wasting much of our time on this segment, our team remain back to your root. Back to your root. If you have been following this segment, you will understand that the same thing that happens in South-South is the same culture with Southeast, Bottom Line, River Line. It's the same thing. It's not just meant to help us understand how our ancestors survived, but it has to help us to understand the damage the Yoruba church, the Nigerian terrorist state, and the British government, how much evil they have done to us. Before now, when we say back to your roots, some people say, India na gomo, India na gomo. Manezioku, oh, more kamo na go. Adia mama, how more gomo, nihina chineke bomo. Anonyo bono bono cho ife chineke, igana ife anime zioku na ime mo. Abino agotani heriku. Mo kan refinu o meni si refe chuku chuku wonde mo chuku wonye mo osonye kefe na nu kefe imejoku le men imemmo no wono kunu keji mani kende ni ji shenye pato makasa just bamboo us everywhere. But of course we must know the truth. Today I am happy that I am ogomo, and then I have to go more. I greet you, my ancestors. How proud I am about you, my ancestors. For you who take the journey ahead of us, you protected us with everything you have, because the Creator is with you. He moves in the water to unite everybody, but yet with the wind, he separates the chaff from the wheat. You made us to understand the will of the Creator. For indeed, the wisest of all men is foolishness before him. And though men may choose to call him any name they wish, but any name that denote an atom of his personality and his sovereignty, they are all fools, and they will burn in hell. You see. And having said that, our topic this evening is traditional way of grooming people. The traditional way that our ancestors used to groom people. We actually tried to look into this study yesterday before the zoo idiot, epileptic, and all of them start misbehaving. We can only get better. This is a promise you have made to them. In IPOB, we can only get better. The earlier everybody understand this and do the needful, the better for all of us. But having said that, we must understand that in the time past, our ancestors understand the need for us, or for them rather, to groom people at different stages and level for more efficiency in the discharging of their duty and obligation to the community. Our ancestors understand that there is need. They understand that we may be the same people, but our approach to issue are different. And as such, everybody's opinion must be respected. This gave both the formation of coming together and organizing different community group, as we are going to consider. Our ancestors understand this truth. You know, when you talk about leadership, if you understand the basic principle that are the foundation of leadership, there won't be problem. The world is just a simple place for all of us to live. The Bible says he has given to us all that pertaineth life and godliness. Except somebody breaks the rule. The British government are thieves. They must steal oil in Biafra land, and then they must blackmail us to continue stealing the oil. And so people remove their mind from the evil they are doing. Why they are stealing the oil? That is why, drawing from the word of Ojukwu, he says slavery is maintained by violence, and until there is counter force, they will die in slave. Having said that, the word is just simple. Hausa, Fulani, Yoruba are gallivanting for one Nigeria. Why? They still unaccounted for. They see us as their food. This is unfair. This is not justice. And this is why we come here every day. But it was not so with our ancestors. That is why no Igbo man conquered any Ijaw man. No Igbo man conquered any Akwa Ibom man. No Akwa Ibom man conquered any Abo man. Because we understand the need for grooming people. Having said that, when you as a leader is appointed, you have principle that governs you. There are a lot of idiots whose duty is to destroy. Respect them. They are idiots. Allow them to be fooling themselves. And there are some who are still very disciplined. Their job is to make sure that the right thing is done. But if you understand, if I know that this person I'm working with is an idiot, I know how I handle those idiots. I let them behave like one Nigeria. At the end of the day, they will be disgraced. They can deliberately target me, blackmail me, frustrate me. But at the end, because I understand mostly how all of them practice. Our fathers understand this. That is why all of us will bear testament that before now, no Yoruba can come to our land and misbehave. Look at Yoruba and Hausa now, jumping up and down, telling us that they are born to rule. This is because we have failed to groom our people. No, I want you to look at that Fulani man, that Hausa man, that Yoruba man with AK-47 on a checking point terrorizing all of us. They were not here before. Any Fulani, Hausa, Yoruba man that cross into Biafra land, they coordinate themselves. But because we have failed to understand the importance of grooming, that is why what is happening to us today. Our ancestors understand the need to groom the hunters group. In those days, we have group known as hunters group. They come together and say, all the hunters gather. Oh, you think they are just there to kill rabbit? They were hunters group. They have a role to play. We will look into it as we progress in this study. They have another group known as fishermen group. You think they are only going there to catch fish? They watch our waterways. Go and check Biafra land waterways now. Fulani controls them. Go and check my Ijaw brothers now. 90% of them can't even swim swimming pool. 90% of Ijaw cannot swim swimming pool now. Throw them inside gutter, they will drown. Fulani now. I remember when our leader began to say, we say Fulani cannot swim river. Today, go to Biafra land waterway. Fulani has taken it because we fail to understand the need to groom. Our ancestors know this truth. Our ancestors understand that they have trader unions group. We have them in Biafra land, but Nigeria controls them. Our ancestors understand that they have community defenders group. After the community defenders group, they have religious group. They have the caretaker committee group. They have the tank crier group. With the presence of this group information, it was easy to manage our community. Without any form of invasion, you could not possibly be a member of any of this group because you want to be. But your gift must make a room for you. They have all this formation, all this group lined up. You just don't wake up and say, I want to be a hunter. I want to be a fisherman. I want to be a caretaker. No, your gift will find you out because the Bible says the gift of a man maketh way for him. We will come there later on. Most of the people with this gift now work for the enemy against their own people. I'm just calling that there be a review in this aspect of our life as a people. In this edition, we will start by reviewing this group so that you know the role they play. This evening, we are going to look at only two. And in next edition, we look at all of them. And so that everybody should get ready and begin to see the need, why we begin to groom our people. And so that we can be able to stand our ground to the end. He said, above all, put on the whole armor. Put on the whole armor of Chukwuoke Kabiama so that you can be able to withstand Hausa Boko Haram AK-47 and Yoruba Fulani slow poison. Put on the whole armor of Chukwuoke Kabiama. But I hope you will understand. Now, like I said, among this group, our ancestors know how to groom people. Number one we are going to look at is the marriage institutional group. They have group that are no, their job is marriage affair. Today is Yoruba that is teaching you marriage affair. This marriage institutional group is made up of man and woman. You, if you are sensible enough, you will understand. This marriage group, their duty is to make sure that our women does not sleep with Yoruba and Hausa. They don't sleep with idiots. They don't. This marriage group are made as there to be sure that our noble women are not married to a hooligan. All this hooligan in Biafra land now, if this group were functional, it is the mad people we give to them to properly treat them well. But you will not understand, but let's continue. This group of people were the one who managed marriage institution. Now, let me digress a little bit. Why Nigeria is insulting us 50 years after they killed our people, 50 years after the genocidal war, they picked one of us. I said one of us because I want people to understand. Many of them are yapping. We are looking at them. But we remind you now, Nigerian, that the dead body of most of those people you killed, and you are telling us you are remembering them, we are still excavating online. Their videos are there. Rejoice, mock at us 50 years after you have killed us. We can't do you anything because we know how you operate. We will continue. Let me point out where I'm going to. And now they picked one of us by the name Onyeka Onwenu. And Onyeka Onwenu, because his father and his mother are pure breed Biafra, she still speak like one. And some of you are very proud, but you do not listen to the undertone in her statement. I am from River State, very good. Yes, I am from Abia State, perfect. And then at the same time, I'm from Imo State, all right. And then finally, I'm from Anambra State, perfect. And then he breaks the camel back. I am also Yoruba, idiot. But I don't blame you, I feel your pain. She's also Yoruba. And she has two sons for Yoruba man. Their name may be Kechukwu or Mbitoru. We will know where their loyalty lie when the time comes. But you will not understand. And now, I tell you, no matter what happened, Onyeka Onwenu loyalty cannot be 100% to Biafran. This is one of our best daughters. She was taken from us. It is not her fault. Many of them today are married to Yoruba people. They were stolen from us. It's not their choice. No wonder Onyeka Onwenu speak with two voices. Imagine if a lioness like that was married to an Igbo man. She would have led another Aba woman riot. But he said, married to a Yoruba man now. If he ginger finish, he go and sleep in Yoruba bed. Don't you people get it? That's why some people come and say, leave Yoruba alone, leave Yoruba alone. I see Yoruba blood speaking in you. You think we don't know what people like Ogbomu they did? Only Miss Blood talk from both sides of their mouth. But we don't blame you for that. Do not let the love of your father destroy your mother. But I must tell you, according to our tradition, Onyeka Onwenu does not have the right to speak for Nwadiana. Onyeka Onwenu does not have the right to speak for Nwadiana. Because her blood lineage has been compromised already. Yes, she's our daughter. But we count our ancestors, count our lineage by our father. His children, Onyeka Onwenu children, can answer Igbo name. They are Yoruba and they will betray us. That is why we talk about oath. You should be lucky if your mother is Yoruba and your father is Igbo. It's better for you. But of course, any of our sisters married to Yoruba, poison us now, fight us now, because you will not have your way. And that is why we are shouting, don't marry Yoruba, don't marry Hausa. God even said, do not intermarry. But Yoruba pastors, they are telling you, tell me any of our sisters marrying Yoruba, Hausa, Fulani, whose life is normal, even our brothers. But this is hate speech. But this is the truth. Because we do not have marriage institution any longer. Now they plant them. They bastardize our blood lineage. They miss our blood lineage. I swear to the Almighty God, I've never met Onyeka Onwenu children. But go and look for them. You will see they look like more Igbo more than me. And Onyeka Onwenu, Yoruba husband, can never look like Yoruba man any longer. Go and look at Fenika Yode and the rest that married Igbo. They look like Igbo already. But you people don't know what they are doing to us. They are watering down our tradition. When the Yoruba now are in charge of our marriage institution, when Yoruba endorse you, you go and pay tight marriage certificate to Hausa. Who guide our marriage institution? And now in their absence, that is all this thing is happening. In those days where marriage institution function, that time that prostitute from Britain come to visit our governors, our mothers will not let them enter. Those people in charge of marriage institution will not let that prostitute from Britain to visit any of our governor. That is an abomination according to our culture. It is sorrow, because when they want to visit Hausa and Yoruba, men go. When they want to tell us we are useless, so they send women to us. If it were those days where men were men, when British send a harlot like Flora Shaw or any other idiot, we send mad people to them. But where are the marriage institution? They are no longer here. It is because of the assets of the marriage institution group, we destroy them in Biafra land. That is why many of our women are no longer married. I know one of them. But this program will not permit me to play her video, her audio broadcast. One of these days we will do that. They know how it's supposed to be. I remember that as a child, the moment any family in Abo give birth to a girl, a daughter, in less than 3 months, in fact, before they even 1 week self, they have married her out. Understand what I'm saying. Our ancestors are not, what do they call it? Is it Philodifia, Philafiafia? That one Buhari is sleeping with small children. How do they pronounce it? It's hard for me. Okay, pedophile. You know, it's hard for me to pronounce. Our ancestors are not pedophile, pedophile in the era. But I tell you, the moment any family in Abo give birth to a girl, an elder will come and marry the girl. And when we grow up with brothers and sister, I remember then I can play with some of our sister, not biologically related, but in the same community. Somebody will say, that girl you are touching like that is Oko wife. And Oko is almost 80 years. And the person they are telling me is Oko wife is almost 3 years. And I couldn't understand it. And with the thought that that small girl is married to a man of 70 years, it's enough to make us discipline. And so this girl begin to grow. Everybody call her Mbo Oko, Oko wife, Oko wife, Oko wife, Oko wife. And one day Oko will die. Or maybe Oko is still alive. Somebody start approaching the girl. Now what they do is that the family will say, this girl is Oko wife. And then you that want to marry the girl, now go and meet Oko. Oko will ask his children, do any of you want to marry this girl? They say no. Then Oko will say, you can marry her out. It was Oko's duty, who is the custodian of that lady. And then they do the marriage right. But if you touch that girl and they find out, you will pay damages to two family. So it was Oko's family duty to monitor that girl. And if me, an indigenous, cannot have access to my community woman, is it an idiot fool and he will do that? But today, Yoruba say it doesn't mean you can go and prostitute. The Lord is there. He's a merciful God. It doesn't mean how much prostitution you have done. Go and ask them, and they are doing it for you. And then they come on social media and say, do you know 20,000 prostitutes repented today, and we give them one room? One room to continue prostitution or what? You think you are deceiving us? Today, our women are not getting married, as we all know. It's not because we don't have men. It's not because majority of our men are in diaspora. Call your nuku, call your nyenta. There is men in diaspora, there is women in diaspora. Something is missing along the line. Something is missing. If we still have this institution in our culture, as it was in the days of our father, you will not marry somebody on Facebook. You will not marry somebody on Twitter. You will understand how it works. Because what our ancestors does is that at the end of the day, this marriage institution create a kind of environment that will help all of us to begin to coordinate ourselves. And so in those days, if you want to do anything, in fact, I'm coming. In those days, you have to talk to a woman for many years before they will agree with you. It then takes tradition after tradition. But today, it is no longer there. The moment they destroy our women foundation, The moment they destroy our women foundation, we are gone as a people. Believe me, we are gone as a people. And having said that, our women must be protected. We must do everything we can and bring them back home. Like I said earlier, our beautiful sisters like Onyeka Onwenu should not even go close to Yoruba, not to talk of any other one. Because they don't love us and they will never love us. Where are the people who manage our institution? Can you tell me you can go and marry a Hausa woman? I'll be back in a minute.
It's not.
said we must continue. Yes, sir, we must continue. Like I said, one or two challenges will come up and we will follow up with them. And so having said what I've seen, or rather before I stopped, you know, one or two issues with them, we correct it. I want our people to understand that if there are people who are managing our marriage situation, a lot of things will not go bad. But having said that, moving with the trend of the moment, the heat of the moment, I see the only way to project what I'm saying to you this evening is by talking about our sister. But like I said earlier, our dearly sister, she stand out among the crowd. When she spoke to Nigerian citizens about what they did to us, I saw the pure blood in her. My heart was broken and I feel her pain. How I wish no Yoruba, no Nigerian touch that woman. How I wish that woman was still young, I would have married her. We have wonderful sister married to Yoruba as we speak, and Hausa as we speak. How can those who hate my father with cruel hatred marry my sister? But like I said, Onyeka Onwenu remain one of the individual that carry the heart of a Biafran. At least in this very moment, she never killed her father for anybody. She remained true to herself. And having said that, our people must understand this marriage institution must start. Can you marry Hausa woman? Or Hausa don't have woman? There are some jihadists set to follow you up. When they finish flogging you cane, you think what the cane is their tradition? They will just say, come marry our sister. The bride price is 50 stroke of cane. Go and marry you, Hausa now. And then by the time they finish flogging you, we'll see how you sleep with that wife. You will even run. These are just plan work. How many Hausa can receive the cane they give to you? If you as a German, Igbo man want to marry Hausa and they will finish the stroke, how many of you at the end of the day will receive that cane? Can Hausa receive that cane? But of course, they know what they are doing. And then in the absence of this, we are in for a very big trouble. I can tell you, Israel cannot manage that problem. Israel is in that problem as we speak. They can't manage it. Don't let them bastardize our blood lineage. We left our women vulnerable, and every idiot can cross and misbehave. 90% of the secret of who we are left with our women. And I can assure you, go to their house, you see we have been replicated. And then we should get ready for it. And like I said, because our time is fast spent, we will go to the other avenue that we want to look at this evening. And that is the grooming of the defenders of the community, the defenders group. This defenders group fall into the category of the boys that smoke Igbo, take goof. So many of them, their head is not at home. They are arm robber by nature. You can't correct them. You can't control them. Our ancestors did not kill them. If our ancestors were here, we were respecting their culture and tradition, Roger Sokorocha would have been among the defenders group. Because when he finished taking Igbo goof, he would start arresting IPOB member and then kill them and jail people who smoke Igbo. I think he said so. He's supposed to be among those group. But now look at what we are doing. We are the one killing three people in this category. Believe me, you don't know what we are losing. They started by calling them militants. They reduced their number. I think the last of them they killed is Don Juan. And when they killed them, you say, welcome development. Oh, they killed Don Juan. Oh, I can begin to mention all their name. Nigerian government killed all of them. You wake up in the morning, you hear Nigerian military combated with Ogoni youth. 45 of the terrorists were shot dead. They will bring out gun. AK-47. They say this was the arm recovered from them. These were the community defenders. Now, let me tell you a secret. In every community, I want you to go and find out who is the CEO of that community. Just go and find out who is the CEO of your community. CSO, rather. Go and find out who is your CSO. You will know that these people are not to be toyed with. My people will say, if you don't want a dog to eat meat, tie the meat on the neck of that dog. Go and watch all the CSO of your community. You will understand what I'm saying. I think that one is still functioning. But they soon set them up. Turn them to ballot rigger and ballot snatcher. We forgot how our ancestors managed them. In those days, they catch you. They know that there is stealing in your DNA. It's not a sin. If you are anointed with the ability to steal, it's not a sin. If you are anointed with the ability to kill, it's not a sin. If you are anointed with the ability to loot, it is not a sin. There is a reason why God put them. If you destroy your own, other people's own will destroy you. Look at Jubri. Buhari is a thief. Very good. Buhari has the anointing to impoverish the people. Awosafulani didn't kill him. He came in 1983. He impoverished everybody. He did a good job for Britain. Now they feel Nigerians have now woken up, are stronger economically. What did they do? They send Jubri back. Look at, he's sending you back to austerity measure. Have you heard America crucify their own that they are armed robber? Have you heard America call this Europe to execute their criminal? The moment you can rob a bank successfully, the moment you can rob any company successfully, you become a hero. They just call you boy, boy. You mean you can still break into that office? You can break that vault? Boy, boy, they give you one, you drink. They say, but the way you are now, you are a threat to national security. But what is there is we will be monitoring you. They now wear them tracker. Let them have some privacy into their, some access into their private life. So when they want to steal oil, do you know how many American, how many France, how many Europe criminals are stealing oil now? They are professional thieves. American, Europe did not kill them. France did not kill them. Because when they need to steal diamond, when they need to steal gold, when they need to steal oil, they send them down to our land. But we have finished killing our own because the people who groom us are no longer there. I don't know if you understand. Look at the ability of Nigerians to steal money. It is anointing. Hausa has not stolen Hausa money, but Hausa Fulani are stealing our money. We are the only people that sees our brother stealing yam because of hunger. We will burn them with fire. But we see the same politicians stealing money. Look at Osinbajo. He's telling you that almost 3 trillion naira has been spent for infrastructure by this Buhari administration. Where are they? That man is supposed to be burnt up. But some people are going to call him Ababa, Ababa. But the point is, who is grooming our people? We need them. Let me tell you a story. There was a time in my community, I have said this before, everybody was causing problem, causing serious problem. The youth, there was situation unrest. People were angry. And some of our chiefs went to invite the army, Fulani army, and asked them to get rid of the boys. The army came in at night, rounded up the community, because the youth thought that they were safe in their father's house. And they took them to the nearby bush for execution. And when they tied them up in that bush, somewhere around the library in Abo, almost opposite to the police station, by Yorogodo there, and then they said to the chiefs, what do we do to these boys? That should be around 1984 or thereabout. The chief said, shoot them, kill them. And one of those, they wear masks. And they were hearing everything they were saying. And one of the army man called the chiefs and said, do we kill these boys? They say, yes, they are disturbing us, kill them. The man said, we will not do that. See, I am an Abo man. And you don't know what you are doing. If we kill these boys, when this your community is under attack, there will be nobody to defend you. These boys may not be doing the right thing, but they are the people they hear about without attacking you. I will advise you, guide them. Guide them. If you kill them, you will die next. And they gave knife to the chiefs and say, it's your choice. Kill them yourself or free them. That is how they freed those boys. Those elders learned that day. Today you cannot infill my community. They call them Ndutu Brog on the Hogu Juni. You can't infill it. Because we understand that in Jabba country, we Jabba Kenya. We understand that there are people who are born to make peace. And there are people who are born to respond to idiots. Today now they have killed all the people protecting the coastal region. You don't hear about Curtis any longer. Shell sponsored the killing. Instead of you grooming them to protect our community, we have been the one grooming them for assassination. And it, all it takes is just blackmail them as you they blackmail IB, IPOB. IPOB came out to defend Biafra land. Majority of the people who are supposed to protect us, they said to us that we are terrorists. In as much as we will talk about the evil of people, talking about the Omotekun, but we commend what they have done. We commend what Yoruba have done. Some idiots come out and set up Omotekun Abi Ekotomo. But the Yoruba understand that they have to groom their people. They supported them. And of course, I will have to stop here. There are people responsible for the grooming of our people. All I want you to understand is that this institution should be reintroduced. Elderly mothers, train our daughter, control our daughter. It is not going to be easy. With the presence of Yoruba Church, it's not going to be easy. But we have to start from somewhere. Stop killing our people. Nobody is a criminal except you make one out of them. As we are speaking today, they say you cannot open bank account in Nigeria again except you pay 75% tax. What of the person that is not working? Do you know Guaja? He must give you 75%. When exactly will Nigerians start thinking about how to help their people? You work very hard to make life ends meet, and then indirectly they collect it from you on checking point, and they collect it from you anywhere. You think they are confident to go and stay in the highway in the north? Boko Haram will collect their gun. But where are our brothers who would have collected gun from all these bastards? We have betrayed all of them. We have betrayed all of them. But I know many of them are still alive. And they are waiting. Asawana, wana. But tomorrow you will betray them. Share will sponsor you to betray them. So that Share can destroy our land and nobody will talk to them. We are going to have youth any longer. Because Share has killed all of them as I speak. As I'm talking to you now, they are blackmailing Emoha people to finish all that is left of them. The blackmail worry. The blackmailing Bayasa. We will kill all our youth and we will support them. If Tompolo did not go to where you go, I will not tell you. By now, they would have killed some Tompolo. And some of us, we say it's a welcome development. But one day, we will wish we never do that. Our ancestors knew that all of us cannot be the same. If you are a thief, I respect you. Thief, respect responsibly. They know cigar kilo, cigar kill. Smokers are liable to die young. But because of their economic gain, they still tell you that they smoke responsibly. Drink responsibly. Who is deceiving who? You want me to tell you, thief is thief, kill thief. Did Jesus kill Judas? Dear friends, it is time to steal responsibly. It is time to do politically responsibly. It is time to do everything you are doing responsibly. And when you are responsible, that means you understand that it is our duty to defend our fatherland. Because if we don't, nobody will. And having said so, I just pointed out something. I'm not saying it to undermine our sister Onyeka Onwenu. It breaks my heart that she's an elderly woman. With the kind of spirit I see in her, I won't say anything. But if our women, as bold as she is, her speech crippled Nigeria. But I tell you, it breaks my heart. It breaks my heart that one Yoruba can put their fitting hand on the diamond like that. We have felt the pain of the evil done to us by these people. And until we see evidence of change, we see remorse for the evil they've done for us, we can only arm ourselves with hatred for them, because this is all we have gotten from them all this while. And then maybe one day they will succeed in killing all of us and then have our land to themselves. Or maybe one day, better still, they will let us go And so they can live and we live also. Or maybe one day we will kill all of them. So we have peace. Either way, all we want is Biafra. And then somebody will say, how does it concern us? It concerns us. If Britain can kill all their women, I mean France can kill all their women that romance with German women, even though all of them are Europe. You don't understand what I'm saying. Where is Mama Taraba? She says she's from Enugu. Married to Hausa. She was actually a seed to blackmail that the Igbo people are Boko Haram. But it didn't work. It didn't work. It didn't work. Our mothers should rise up and direct our daughters. Our men must protect our women. Stop killing our youth. Because one day you will need somebody to defend you. You don't necessarily have to be a member of IPOB. But the greatest mistake you will make is to fight against IPOB. I must tell you the truth. Don't fight against us. We want our freedom. But we don't speak for everybody. But this issue can be debated. That is why we call for referendum. But either way, the truth must prevail. Our need must be met. Our request must be granted. It's as simple as that. Of course, at this moment, our line is open, just temporarily, and then we move to another segment. I'll be back in a minute. At this moment, our lines are open. Caller on WhatsApp, are you still there? Caller on WhatsApp.
From here.
Good evening. Go ahead, please.
Marzi, I just want to use this opportunity to appreciate you for your good job. Okay, guide and protect you and your family. Marzi, may he do the same to our leader, his deputy, every principal officer that's working at the school. And I hear you worldwide. Well, okay, can guide and protect us. Marzi, my name is Igbeto. I'm calling from London here. Marzi, we have seen everything that is going in our land. And then, first of all, I still need to appreciate IPOB worldwide, those of you that is doing the needful. Marzi, once more again, I will still appreciate Tonya Kawana. I still appreciate that lady. She makes me, when I watch that video, you know, I don't usually get tears coming out from my eyes. Nearly dropped from my eyes.
I wept.
I'm telling you.
We lost the jewel. We lost the diamond.
I'm telling you.
I wept. I'm still feeling it. If I can rewind the hand of time, I will make sure I will marry Onyeka Onwenu from her mother's womb. I wept. Go ahead. Let me not interrupt you.
Marzi. I'm not that type of easily person that's trying to bring that here, but I, I, At work today, I just my all my system just shut down. I just keep asking myself, I wish our people could wake up. That is what I was telling myself at work. I wish our people could wake up. What is holding our people? That lady was there speaking her mind, telling Nigerian government in their face that they are workers.
It touched me.
That is what she did.
People may not understand why I use her as a reference point. This is one of the best women we have, and she has been taken from us. Because as far as I'm concerned, if the husband is a Yoruba, they stole the jewel from us. It is the blood of her father, original mama and papa, that speaks through her. And that is our ancestors. Honestly, what I said is not to undermine her. But what I said is our people should be very careful. These people are scanning our beautiful women and taking them away. And they tell you the beautiful ones are not yet born. Who said so? Our mother should watch out. Our brother should wake up and protect what we have. The secret of our land is with our women. These people know the truth. And if we must protect our land, our life, we must protect them all over. Imagine if Onyekonwenu was married to my father. Imagine the kind of child they will give birth to. You think our leader's parents were missed up? He can talk the way he's talking. But of course, we're not against all these things. We want to save our race. If there was something wrong with my the way I come from, I will mellow down. Ketu cannot call Paul, tell Paul that you are too black. But they understand this truth. They know what they are doing. But we are very simple people. And our simplicity has brought us here. Go ahead, my brother.
Yes, Mazi. That is the place I met her, where she said that she married a Yoruba man. I just feel like I don't know why. I want to make it clear to Yorubas that they are listening tonight. Yorubas, the Afrans and Igbo people are not your enemy. You understand? And I want to go to Mazi Oni's program this morning to listen. Mazi, if you have the opportunity to play back those of our people who did not listen to that program, the only program this morning today, is one of, in fact, when I keep listening, I keep repeating that program today. This afternoon, I was like,
no, after they finish killing us, Yoruba come out and congratulated the Yoruba. Thank you for believing in yourself. The Igbos, if we have listened to them, they would have deceived us. By now, all of us would have been crying. Go and look at the script. He said, yes, Yoruba didn't fight Igbo. We fought Igbo individually, not as a people. But today, they will regret by the action they have made. They can be blaming people for their circumstance. But after hitting the road, I told you, Onyeka Onwenu's statement exposed them. I was touched.
Yes.
But I wept. When I know that Yoruba can touch a diamond of us like that, it's unfortunate anyway. Thank you very much. We must continue. Biafrans across the
yes, Mazi. Mazi. The what I did was to send a message to Goman through China television. People were commenting. You know, Mazi, there's one thing I want our people to understand. I sent a message to Gowan, nasty one. Do you know what happened? Somebody commented on the message, and then he came back to me. Somebody give it a thumbs up, and he came back to me, and then I saw it. Do you know what I did? I went to see what messages that I sent to Gowan. And do you know what they did? The bad ones, because if you read the message yourself, I wonder who was this message. You know what just television did? You know what people did? They remove it.
That is
because even if you see the message, I said something very, very ugly on the message. You know what they did? They went and removed it and leave the other ones there. They removed it. Because that's the word to see. But we are getting there. Mazi, thank you for giving me
this. Thank you very much. Continue. We must continue. Can you hear me call on the line?
Yeah, good evening, Mr. Mazi Oyinbe.
Good evening from here.
My name is Azuka Chukwu from Umueme Unit, Aba. Please, I thank you very much for all your education, how you try to let us understand ourselves. God bless you for all you've been doing. Hello? Okay. So, on the 1st of November last year, I sent you my record when you asked for data. Up to now, nobody has reached me. Nobody has talked to me. I don't know what happened.
What you have to do is, if you have sent your name and nobody respond to you, keep resending it until they respond to you. My duty is to make sure that I continually resend it to the department who are to follow you up. And okay. Your duty is to continue resending it until somebody will respond to you. Because I have made up my mind that they must be receiving it until they tell me done. Or the people respond that they have been contacted. So do not
all
give
right,
up.
I will do that.
Continue
thank
doing
you very
that.
Much.
I will be doing the follow-up. Thank you, my brother. We must continue.
Okay, God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you. Yes, a caller on WhatsApp. Caller on WhatsApp, are you there? Of course, he's listening to his radio. When you call, please move away from your radio set and focus on your phone. Caller on the line, your name and where are you calling from? Go ahead, please.
My heart is, I can't, and I don't know, I'm not going to explain this tonight. And if you can remember, the athlete, I mean, many of our juniors, many of our precious women have just gone up like that. We are not marrying you because of love. I have said it several. Because if you come in contact with many of them married there, they are with them to today. Children have gotten grandchildren. How did that happen? They will trust you, so they have to be married there. But on our ladies today, will be happy to open their leg to uncircumcised human beings. I'm not really, how can you qualify yourself? Why they deny me the counselorship in Abuja? It's because of I have decided that I will never send myself to the uncircumcised useless human beings. I contested the city center. My data, everything is here until today. But I said no, that as a precious person that I cut myself as a precious jewel. I can never open myself to all these religious senators. Even my brother Chukwumelej, I'm not retiring the office. Give me my position. They are talking nonsense. How many of us today will stand up? I didn't have godfather, I don't have godmother. For that election, I spent 1.something million naira. But my brother, I was denied because of this very condition now. But because if you sell, nobody will kill you. If somebody will just deny you your right, but they can, I know that I've achieved something. Many of them, they are just playing with our neighbors like toys. Coming to, if you look at them from here to say, look at your neck on when my sister. I am crying. I am crying within myself. Then they tell you, Jesus has died. And that was, I said that you are a stationer from those useless pastors. They can never stand there and tell me the truth. They call themselves, they were called, the pastors are reverend, useless things that refuses. They smoke it in their mouth. Then tell you that nothing happened. You can marry Yoruba, you can marry Hausa. Then you have forgotten the just the fact that you are not in a center marriage. The Bible said, according to them, that yes, they will bring their gods and spare you. And they have been doing it. How long will we continue in this condition? All our women, none of them, they are regretting. There is no hand that will allow their women here. Then coming to small boys. From 2 years, I was sat there, we start to smoke in Vietnam. Even the highest cocaine solution. If you capture them from that, yeah, they will tell you from, yeah, you release them, you release them. Look at people. They are killing us every day. Killing our weapon that men that we use for something good. Is there anyhow that you will do without that is negative and positive? Can it work that we can use any negative? It is God that put them there. If you come to our egos, they have their poison part and abundance. They have their witches and wizard school. But how come that our owner is bad?
We get to that place. We are just looking
how at can they people. Destroy our culture and desire and they will go through? And our people, they are still there. Useless people. I don't know whether they direct the mix in their brain. I don't know. Let me tell you. I'm aware now that a man they can do something that you put in put it on when they shoot you the blue bullet will go. Where did they do that? Where this knowledge from? How come one in it is something that they're using because of course they are using. They're doing nothing here.
All the people who have defended our share has sponsored their execution. They call them militant. They call them cultists. Who is grooming this group of people?
Eh? All these boys don't want it, they have killed all of them. And if it's you, being your brother, we go outside them. How many of them, how many of those useless people in outside river will they bring out? Allah, this and that, how many of them will they bring out for them to kill? They want to render us useless. But I said, I'm not going to be able to do it. If not for people, can they say, allow them to come and practice here, those in Salemia. But because of the lands and Chukwu Abiana that have been directing all those things, they are in my own village. Right from time, I don't criticize, I treat them as my friends. Even when I contested, I will go to them and give them what they want. They are the ones to feed you back. And there is no harm in the family. They cannot act again. That is what they do to us. But I pray that they will suffer everything that they have done to us. Only women, they will suffer for it. All these are best.
Thank you very much.
I overall in my own position, I will have recruited them even as I am doing now. I will recruit them more and more. But it is not my best because as little as I have been trying my best. My Zenib,
I go to you.
You will live and witness the coming back of our great ancestors. As our tradition, as our religion, you will receive more blessings. And I know that we that bless you here have a reason. That nothing shall ever touch
you. Thank you very much.
There is no how any idiot call themselves. We are Ramachandran Hande, we are on the winning side. I said, as we are there reminding you on daily basis to bring those closer to our nature. You will leave one for us. Imagine the Carlo, who's a little bit older than the Hobby Afra. We are black. I don't have any to do it. Because we will say that now. I will be Okoch. No, please, we are not. You need no help. No, many times they will reach. As all the Colonel Hammer that they will come to Ozana, draw themselves to Ozana, because they are Hanama. You need to handle it. Bam, bam, bam. And I ain't in the right place. No, 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 no. I don't know how you bring all these women back. But you need to take us what I say.
Of course, that is engaged. The Yoruba should come back home, including our men and women. That is your job. Talk to our women. Thank you. We must continue. Our mothers must begin to redirect our women. The secret of every clan, every generation, every tribe, every tongue is hidden with the women. And I tell you, anyone, our Safulani Yoruba take from us, exposes our everything about us. They have succeeded in killing every people that guide our land. Shell is the one sponsoring them. But why are they not talking about Kaduna Marine? Why are they not talking about Sokoto Marine? All these are Fulani cultists in River State. But don't worry. Are you still there, caller on WhatsApp?
Yes, I am here. Man. Good evening from here.
My rabbi. Go ahead, please.
You know, Derigi, I greet your fans all over the world. Friends of their fans and lovers of freedom. I'm Rabbi Charles. I'm calling from United Kingdom. Mother Onyibe, there is something I just want to comment that I heard you guys talking about, and I'm checking it up online. I saw the clip on Channel Television with Patu Tommy, Onyekonwenu, who spoke, and I'm looking at what our people are saying. Let me say this. A lot of us are asking, why are they marrying our women? Why are these enemies marrying our women? When I say enemies, you know
they
whom they
us,
are.
They hate us and they love our women. Something is not right. Go ahead.
I saw this thing in South Africa. But people don't, I don't know if people saw it the way I saw it over there. You know, when people are in power, when the minority are in power in South Africa, what they did was they systematically reduced the black community to zero. That if you marry a black man, there is no glory there. It's like you are marrying into suffering, into humiliation, into poverty in general. You are married. There are a lot of stigmas, and you will never. The only black person that you will see having a white woman beside him or behind him is maybe an artist, or a footballer who is being paid in pounds sterling and dollars or euros. That time there was no euros, but in the local currency of European communities, if they are paying you in Deutschmark or in Deutsche Gelder and pound sterling, then there is a kind of glory that if you see him, you will say, oh, this is the footballer, and the white woman will marry you. Then that means at that point racism is dead. That's why I don't believe in racism. Racism means they have and they have not. If you are a millionaire today, a black person, you have millionaire white people around you, so you can interact, you can dine together, you can go to dinner, you can go and have breakfast together. So when I bring this thing back home to what our sister, people are saying, oh, she will lost. I heard you saying we lost somebody. I thought maybe she passed, she died. But when I listened carefully, I knew I got the message that she married somebody that is from a different tribe in that contraption. The reason is this: what they did to us, the owners of the wealth in that contraption, is what our men are doing today is like Ikeke Torie. And that's why you see a lot of our men compromising, sabotaging, and licking their ass or whatever in order for them to have that a little bit of a success. And it is little. And even the well-to-do millionaires, they have managed to reduce them to zero, close their businesses. So if a broke man is coming for you, a beautiful, good-looking woman, a well-educated woman, because you marry me because I'm from your tribe and I'm broke. I don't think the women will do that. They might even marry a foreigner, maybe somebody from another European that is well-to-do, but not to have that stigma and marrying a local Igbo man and who is reduced to zero. This is the reason why the affirmative action I mentioned is what leads to all these things, that our women will not see good things in us. They don't see all the good things. Like, if you know, like, why is it that people from Europe, when they get back home, they will have advantage? The reason is because of the economic advantage. You will see some stark illiterate in Europe here doing cleaning. When they get back there, they will marry a medical doctor or a nurse and bring her over. When she gets here and gets her document, everything is true, then she will look around and say, wait a minute, am I settling with you? Then she will go for divorce and now go for somebody else. So brothers and sisters listening to me, our case, the Onyeka's case is not isolated. It is just the same thing. So if what they did to our men is just to reduce our men to zero, like you can imagine I'm hearing in Nsukka somebody buying wheelbarrows for young men to be pushing wheelbarrow. Now, those people pushing wheelbarrow, if you push wheelbarrow for 5 years and you see a beautiful lady and you want to go and ask the father for the blessing to give you the that you saw an apple in the house, the man will ask you, what do you do for a living?
You see,
obviously, they may even
wheelbarrow.
Look, you forget about the thing, Naga. They will identify you. They will identify you before you arrive. They say, are you not the guy that I saw at Nkwonsuka or Afonsuka pushing wheelbarrow? Yes, I have pushed wheelbarrow. I have 10 boys pushing for me. They said that is not what we are looking for. I'm sorry. They want the daughter. What led you to go to make this kind of decision? So if they reduce you economically to zero, your women will be vulnerable. That is what is going on. Your women will be vulnerable and others will take them because women don't like to go in a place where they will suffer. It's all over the world the same. They won't go. If I come back now, I want to marry 10 women. If I have the dough, they will follow me because they see this man is earning in pounds, sterling, and dollars. And they will go. Even the good one, they won't follow. So this is why our women are fleeing and getting married to them. What we can do to correct this is to get our nation back. That is when our leader said it. That is when our glory, our respect, our dignity will be restored to us. So let's team our hands together and get our nation Biafra. Biafra or nothing. They can go with their one Nigeria. Part will tell me, I thank you for standing strong, but be courageous and be bold to speak more because they did more injustice and killings to our people, and they cannot just come wake up all of a sudden.
They are still excavating their dead body, and they are celebrating to mock us.
Imagine. My brother, thank you very much.
Thank you, Rabbi, for throwing more light into that area. Our people must understand. I am talking to our women this evening. The group responsible for the grooming of our women, you are not doing your job. Believe me, let me digress a little bit. There is a group in my place. Women come together. It's women group. Before they come gather to advise themselves on how to be a good wife or how to raise up good children. But do you know in Biafra land, 90% of such women now, they buy Gouda and Hero in this women gathering? This is abomination. In fact, there is one in Abo. They are called Onyebudie. Onyebudie. I won't end the rest of them. Onyebudie. Onyebudie. That is, if you kill your husband, then they send another slogan. This is abomination. Where are this culture? Where are this tradition? Of course, my brother on the line, are you still there? Caller on the line, are you still there? Yes. Good evening from
Hello,
here.
Mazenive.
Good evening from here. Go ahead, please.
Good evening. Yeah, thank you for taking my call. This is Abigail from London. Before I enter what I want to say to you, Rabbi Charles, sometimes when you talk, we don't hear what you're saying. So I think you need to stay in a different place, location. Because when you speak, it's not, it doesn't come out clear.
Are you sure it's not from your side? Because I can hear him loud and clear. Are you sure it's not from your side?
Yeah, you can hear, but we that listen, sometimes we don't listen. We don't hear all of them.
It's noted.
Mazonibe, thank you for your today's analysis. Can I start from Onyeka Onwenu? Onyeka Onwenu, you understand a little bit of what you are saying, but you only understand the 30% of it. What I want to let you know that the UK is talking now. I want to let you know that the failure of Biafra man after the war lead us to where we are today. And don't talk about your problem or your relationship with your bouncer. It's not what we care to know. It is a mistake in the highest order. And we Biafra youth will not make that folly, that stupid mistake. You know, when they cut me off in Facebook, I can say everything, talk about Igbo against them. Once you mention Fulani, we don't want to live with you no more. They cut you off. This is the language. Even this word I'm using, Home Office is going to use it to penalize me. Because Fulani is doing the job of British. He makes them money. He makes their pocket grow. They are trying you to strategize on your WhatsApp, on your tweeting. Say to British that we don't want to live with Fulani. That one pains them more. That's the word. We don't want to live with Fulani no more. And again, African Union. We need new African Union. One that we stay with Fulani, the new one that we stay with Biafra. So that's, we're going to understand that. That is where we are going to. Something is lacking. You mentioned it, Mazi Onyibe. Something is lacking, and that is what I said about the politician we got, that immediately after the war, it doesn't happen like that other country. After the war, somebody kill you. How can somebody kill you, kill your people, and you go back to them and start mingling around with them? It doesn't work like that, you see, because the people who have the mind to kill you will do more, and this same system have they started. Just watch how Fulani people is parading about, from Sudan to Egypt, they are moving down to Nigeria because nobody needs them. Why do you want them? Why are you allowing them to come? Why are you? I understand your problem, dear friend politician. I want to let you know that you are African. You are black person. You're supposed to be defending black race. If it is money that you are, money is your problem. You don't ask because of money. That is why I'm going to Fulani. Because I need money to pay my bill. Can't you sit down and say, what is this money for? Who made it? Why can't I have it? Why must I go to Fulani person to ask for money? This is what you got to sit down and ask yourself this question. Because I keep cautioning white people. Why must you have right over my currency? The money I use, you got more power over it, and I don't. And yet I'm using it. This is what we're going to ask now. Because different politicians have been, you know, they have their brain have been channeled into money. That money is what they are going for. The same thing applicable to Biafra woman. Money, and she need it. She wants to pay her bill. She wants to look good. Then it's time for we Biafra youth to question that money. We must question what is money. If we don't like it, we go to work a different system of business. If it's going to be trade by butter, we go back to trade by butter. White people cannot control us no more. White people cannot, not to talk about Fulani people. It's time to push on this currency. Monetary system, we must push on it. We don't have it. We don't need it. Because this is fooling our people. This is killing our people. This leads a different woman to become a prostitute. To who? A Fulani person. Fulani, how come? And you see a Brazilian person, a Fulani will come and rape your woman. And a Biafran man will be blaming his woman. Blaming. Why did she go there? Oh, she put on a pint. And what did you want a Fulani to do? I think you're stupid. It is your responsibility. You, a Biafran man, it is your responsibility to do what? Protect your woman. If you protect Onyekonwenu, Sonia Dey wouldn't have married her. If we, as we and Yoma people, if we protected Marianne, Babangida,
Marianne's own was that she was kidnapped. She was adopted by people celebrating adoption. She was Bongo Sikwe wife. So, she was married to Bongo Sikwe. War chased Bongo Sikwe away, like you were saying. The man was not there to protect her. And then Babangida catch her. Very beautiful damsel. And somebody's wife become the Babangida wife. And that idiot will come and talk to us today. But may God be with all of them. Go ahead, please.
So that is it. Dear friends, youth, it is a game changing now, yeah? We are now moving to a different system of life. Our women is our future. We must protect our women. Any day, from today upwards, any day you hear that Fulani rape a Biafran woman, you see the whole places in the whole land Fulani lives. Organize yourself and go there and burn that place back, straight ahead. Any day you hear a Fulani person rape a woman, go there and burn that any place Fulani lives in our land.
Thank you very much.
That is what that is the next,
my time
the next
is
level
up
now.
For this segment.
And again, you see all these police that is staying in Biafra land today, they pass a bill. Pack your things and go, and they are still there. Majority, just put your ear off because I know you're religious. I used to be, I'm not anymore. A Ogugwa from Akukwibo is no more a religious person. Please, in the Makesi Agwago, in the Makesi Falosi, in the Makesi Atamosu, if for that place, you see that place, police is keeping us as his place for checking point in the whole of Biafra land. Go and poison them, all of them. That is your job. If you don't do it, if Biafra come and we hear somebody Paramaramosu, because when we need you, we did not come. Lastly, please, people from Akukwibo, you know, Shimere North local government area, Anyoma, Akukwibo, Ela, Atoma, Ebu, Animalo, Omicholona, all these people living in this area, are you in diaspora? I need only people living in diaspora. Please come, contact George Onyibe. George Onyibe will give you my number. Please, can we be free? Okay?
Thank you very much.
You cannot stay in Europe, and 95% of the money you make goes to white people, and yet, even 1% you cannot throw for your freedom. It is madness. If what you got is the language of that country, it doesn't work like that.
Thank you very much.
Nobody has it.
Thank you very much. And of course, this is where we draw the curtain for this segment. Biafrans across the globe, we must focus on what we want and what we need. In this segment or this series we are going to look into, we want to look at how our ancestors were able to groom everybody. Today, we look at the aspect of marriage. It's a humiliation for any of these people to come and be taking our women, the best among our people, some of the best. A lot of things can contribute to it. Our mothers should rise up and defend, tell their daughter the truth. Yes, they impoverish all of us. We must not sell the next generation. When we talk about bastardizing of blood lineage, they don't turn head upside down to do it. Systematically, meticulously, they water down our blood. My brother who just called now, he's from Akukwibo in Niger Delta, but he's not Igbo man. But if he doesn't have reappearance, he will never know what is going on. And having said that, Share campaign has masterminded the killing of our vibrant youth. They call them terrorists. They call them militant. Some of us support them. We aid them. And as we speak today, most communities are left vulnerable. You have Fulani with AK-47. You even have Fulani secret court everywhere in River State. You know of Sokoto Marine, DSS know them, Kaduna Marine, all the way from Sokoto to Kaduna to Maiduguri to Kwankwasu. All of them have their Marine. These are courties in Burukli. But who the hell is deceiving who? Sometimes if we say the truth, it pains you. But why? I will stop here. It is time to groom our people. It is time to begin to regroom our people. The absence of them makes us vulnerable. I'll be signing off temporarily, but I'll be back in no time.
I get the nugget. 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 I get the nugget.